Welcome to video lecture series in Sociology. Today we are going to discuss chapter 7 titled as Mass Media and Communications from your textbook Social Change and Development in India. This chapter is divided into four parts. So far in the chapter we have discussed about the features, functions and types of mass media. We have discussed about the difference between the traditional and modern means of mass communication. We have also discussed about the emergence and role of mass media during the British colonial rule and how the nationalist and the social reformers used media as a channel to generate awareness among masses during the colonial times. Today in this part, we will discuss about the emerging trends in mass media in India and its impact upon people. In the previous lectures on this chapter, we have learned about the important role that media played during the struggle for independence. The government after independence, while formulating policies for national development, set up a subcommittee on communication under the National Planning Committee to offer recommendations for development of communication. Realizing the vast size of India, both geographical and demographic, there was a need for a medium to communicate that can touch lives of millions of people spread across different regions. In India, the role of media is not just restricted to dissemination of information and offering entertainment. In a developing country like ours, where a large percentage of people are above poverty line, where there is widespread unemployment and disparity in regional development, media has a greater role to play than just inform and entertain the public. Media also has a responsibility to educate people. Media helps a democracy to realize its true spirit and function effectively. How does it ensure that? Media is a source of informing citizens about the developments in the society, thereby helping them to make informed choices. Media also keeps a check on the elected representatives of a democracy by highlighting what they have and have not done for the masses, and in a way making people accountable for their roles and responsibilities. In order to realize its true potential and spirit, media ideally needs to operate in a democratic framework. This framework should be free from governmental or private control or interference. It needs to be autonomous and independent to pursue the goal of catering to public interest. Although media is supposed to play a role of public sphere that provides people a channel for rational public debate, where people can discuss issues openly without the fear of state or the other groups, but in reality, it does not happen. Moreover, if on one hand there is a need for creating platforms for diverse voices to thrive in a democracy, at the same time, it is the social responsibility of the media to remain objective, unbiased, and observe code of conduct and ethics strictly. Scholars such as Barnett are of the view that in contemporary times, the actual meaning and essence of public sphere is breaking down. Instead of voicing the genuine concerns, media has become a tool in the hands of powerful and influential for expressing their particular interest rather than general interest of the society. This shows that increasingly media is being used to serve the personal interest of a section of society instead of general public or masses. During a speech delivered on freedom of information in March 1962, Pandit Nehru had expressed a similar concern. He had said that, I'll quote, "The mass media, which are very useful, have an element of danger in them in that they may be distorted for private aim. The rich group within the country or the rich nations outside the country can flood the country and the world through the means of mass media with its own view of things, which may or may not be the correct view. Driven by some interest, media agencies can hide facts, distort reality, project a false image, or blow issues out of actual proportion. And the core values of objectivity and maintaining integrity are compromised upon. There are many such instances where media has influenced the perception of people both ways, positive and negative, by presenting news and ideas. We'll discuss these points in details in a while in this lecture only. But soon after independence, the government announced a development-oriented policy emphasizing on industrialization and agricultural reform to alleviate poverty and improve social, economic, educational conditions of people. The issue of using modern communication acquired high priority under these circumstances as a developmental resource during the Nehruvian era. Under Nehru's leadership, the planners explored the prospects of using radio as a development agent, that is, a channel for dissemination of information, generating awareness, and enlightening people in the countryside and towns on developmental issues and policy adopted by the government. Radio had greater and deeper penetration among masses as compared to any other means of communication during that time. Newspaper was limited to literate people, and TV only few could afford. Keeping in mind the socio-economic composition of the majority of population in India, radio was an obvious choice as compared to television. The planners of that time were of the view that many in India cannot afford television, and thus communication regarding developmental issues will remain restricted to a particular section of society, leaving out vast majority of people. In fact, looking at the condition of people at that time, even radio was beyond the capacity of large number of people. After independence, media acquired a special place for itself in India, and the nature and content of media has undergone massive changes after the British rule. One can understand these changes by dividing them into two categories, the positive changes and the negative changes. Let us discuss these changes one by one. Looking at the positive developments first, the advancement of technology has brought major structural changes in the field of mass communication and media since independence. If you look at the print media, then both the form and content of print media has undergone major change. For example, look at the type and quality of printing with new designs and color schemes. It's now more attractive and also far more economical as compared to the past. Development in the field of print technology and market forces are determining the nature of growth of print media in India now. The developments in the field of communication and technology have helped in reporting news items and stories from different corners of the world as soon as they happen, which is also called as live reporting on screen. Another important development has been the rise of the level of literacy among people, and growing awareness has also led to increase in demand for media services. Some major newspapers in India sell millions of copies every day. Along with English dailies, newspapers in regional languages are also high in demand. Print media is no longer confined to presenting its product in material form now. One can access these papers in digital form on computers through internet. All the major newspapers are available or accessible through the internet now. Even the news channels are available online. Not only they flash news as it comes, but they keep on updating the information on their websites as well. To cater to the audience to know what is happening globally, the news programs and newspapers offer wide coverage of international events, including sports, entertainment, films, and general items. The strict boundary between print and electronic media in terms of its content is gradually fading away, as both newspapers and magazines are now available as e-papers or e-magazines. An important element related to mass media is growth of advertising industry. There are many factors that have contributed to the growth of advertisements or the advertising industry. These are global capitalist forces or growing market economy, development of means of communication and technology, growth of mass media, and growing consumerism has also contributed to the rise of advertising industry. In general, the mass production and a wide variety of goods available in the market has also contributed to the advertising industry in a very positive fashion. Whatever may be the factor behind advertising, it has become an important part of mass media in many ways. Mass media is a channel used for advertising now. In fact, advertising is a major source for revenue for mass media companies. In some cases, it accounts for almost 70% to 80% of the total revenue of that enterprise. Advertisements occupy major space in print media, like in magazines and newspapers, and time slots between TV and radio programs. The media agencies earn revenue from these advertisements. If you look at any newspaper, almost half of the paper space is full with advertisements. So is in the magazines. On TV, all programs have regular intervals or ad breaks. So is the case on radio. The percentage of time of actual program or space of the news item is gradually reducing, making way for advertisements. The companies advertise their products to people through media only. Media showcases a particular product. When you consume it, both the company producing the commodity and media agency or channel advertising it tend to gain. The growth of mass media and associated activities such as advertising, production, anchoring, etc. has also resulted in one more important thing, that is opening up of a large number of such specialist job opportunities, particularly for women in the field of media. As such, globalization and forces of modernity are challenging the traditional attitude towards working women. Women are now taking up jobs in large numbers outside household. In fact, they form a substantial percentage of workforce in service or tertiary sectors, the sector which comprises of media and mass communication as well. Media has also played a crucial role in discussing intense issues pertaining to status and empowerment of women in society. Yet another important development is that the growth of media industry has generated a demand for professionals having formal education in media studies or having a degree in mass communication. Mass communication is a specialized field. The demand for such education has led to rise in number of institutes offering courses and degrees in the field of mass communication. A large number of young and talented people find this as a challenging career option, with benefits of having good salaries and ability to shape people's choices. There are many specialized branches in the study of mass communication related to films, TV, production, editing, etc. In electronic media and in the field of print media, content writing, journalism, including financial, investigative, political, cinema studies, etc. Let us now also discuss some of the negative trends observed in the mass media industry in the last 20-30 years. Unlike past, when print media was owned by middle class or upper middle class intellectuals and electronic media was primarily owned by the state, today media is owned by big corporate houses. Media in the contemporary times has become a business or an industry where companies invest money to make profit. Earlier, media was emphasizing more on its role to inform and educate people, although it entertained also, but it had a sense of social responsibility. However, with corporatization of media, the trends are changing. Programs and products are being produced by media houses that sell more and help them make money or profits. Advertising is also a part of it. The nature and content of media is designed in order to derive as much profit as a commercial enterprise can make. The whole focus of media has shifted on entertainment, even if it becomes low in quality and standard at times. Neither the interest of the weaker sections nor important national issues are being discussed seriously. The press in contemporary times has become largely instrumental in deciding what political, economic, social, and cultural issues need to be discussed. In fact, it is setting the agenda for discussion by opening up issues for debates. Distortion of facts, misreporting of news, creating and portraying false images of situations is commonly being done to serve the interest of small section of people, which may include politicians or big business houses. Of late, a new trend has emerged in which some of the prominent cases are being so widely and passionately discussed in media that it leads to formation of a strong public opinion or sentiment that sometimes forces judiciary as well. This is called as trial by media as well. It may be both positive or negative, but it certainly uses media to make sentiments. With emergence and entry of big corporate houses in the field of media, the small and medium-sized media agencies are facing a crisis of survival. Big enterprises invest more and are driven by profit motives. With such motives, both explicit and implicit form of corruption is plaguing media. It is not easy to discuss about various dimension, factors and actors influencing mass media in totality in contemporary times. But one thing we can be sure of or agree upon is that media is certainly a force for change, and media itself is undergoing a lot of changes. In fact, it has gone through a lot of changes since independence. To conclude, let's summarize what we discussed in this lecture. We started our discussion with emergence of mass media in modern India in the initial years after independence. we discussed about how media was used as a channel, particularly the radio, to communicate regarding the developmental policies of the government after independence. We also discussed about the positive changes and the negative trends that have come up in the field of mass communication or mass media. We discussed about the emergence of a new set of professionals in the field of media communication and how women are gaining entry into the mass media and tertiary sector in the economy. In the next part of this chapter, we'll discuss about the mass media and communication, particularly in the last 20 and 30 years. Till then, you can enjoy reading this part of the chapter. Thank you.